Rexxar versus Morgul!
Let the hunt begin.
Maybe I'm supposed to keep everyone because I can play two on turn two. Yeah, maybe that's wrong. Because, like, why is this not a, why is this my deck unless it also serves the purpose as a one drop, right? I think I need to start keeping it. I mean, obviously we got better ones, but I think we always lead with that to get three damage on turn two. There's some reason to, like, do this one, obviously, because if I ping, I get... Maybe this is the wrong card, too, by the way. Like, it's good and exactly when we have one drop, but then no double one. But in situations like this, this might be worse than a 2-1. I guess we start working on this shit? I don't know. I mean, this is kind of weak against Maelstrom Portal, right? We got some value, though. We have the dragon into Dragon Hammer, or Storm Hammer. He's going for the two. Interesting. Pretty sure we keep him off the board. I mean, he just showed me a reason to keep him off the board. Playing Soul the Murloc, and cards like War Leader also, you know, want me to clear the Murloc, so we're gonna assume he's a Murloc deck here. I mean, he is a Murloc deck, right? He played two Mermaids into a Soul the Murloc. Alright, so we got Dragon Fire. Hit him in the head for three versus... That's kind of the only play, right? Ooh, that's a nice one. Hungry Dragon is interesting because I can play it next turn, but this plus hero power is not a terrible turn. This one might be better somehow because of Hex, but like, he's a Murloc deck. Does he have room for Hex in his deck? Yeah, hero power is pretty good considering I have two of these now. Alright, so you get the 4 mana 7/7 dealt with. Now the, scariest thing from him is going to be some sort of Murloc, right? Nisha, I guess we're looking for? To my side. Or Leok, right? Leok was the right one. Which one do we do? This is interesting because this, by hero power, we get this going and we grow these, whereas this is just kind of what you could do on six mana. We'll see. We could just start going face, right? Like, because we got 7, 10, 12. Ah, we'll just go with it. I can't play two. He's gonna be real low. In fact, he's at 1. So, as long as we don't lose here, we're good. How do we lose? I don't think we can lose. We got a taunt, so. If I didn't have a taunt, would I be capable of losing? If he, like, played War Leader into the, give all your mer- No, I don't think there's any way, right? There's just not enough mana. Stormbringer does cost 6. Yeah, that card, right? If he did like two of those with a War Leader, was that possible? It might have been. Well played. Well, that was the mistake. We gave him... We got too many animations there. We should have just tagged with the one. I do have a quest to play dragons, so we can slowly work on that with this deck too. 1 out of 12. Might have to go look at one drops again. Is the lowliest card the white card? It wasn't bad there. They did grow.
Your soul shall be mine. Let the hunt begin.
Now let's just keep all the ones, and then this is where I wish I had a silence right against Warlock, because at some point attacking phase is not going to be good anymore.
None will survive.
So we can go Lonely Squire Coin Shard, Hero Power him, and then go High Queen Hero Power.
No. Trust me.
That's pretty good, actually, I think. That definitely was good there. And protect this thing. Might defile. That's fine, I guess. I mean, that'd be annoying. I guess we just play these two, right? Order matters. I could play these now. Is there a difference? I mean, I make this more of a threat. I don't know. That might be wrong. It's weird, right? Because this grows, but I would have an extra 2 damage on the board if I did these first. I mean, we could draw 3 drop, in which case having this would have been bad. I mean, actually, Animal Companion works with this too. Maybe I did do that wrong, because now, like... yeah, now looking back, I can't do everything I wanted, actually. We're using... I mean, he's 4 lower, technically. We're not in a super rush to get this out. That's true. I don't know if this is the right 3. It is value, though, because it draws itself, and then it can draw the Corruptors. They're always nice, even though they're nerfed. I don't know, maybe that's wrong. It just matches up well against a Belcher, so we'll just play it. Might get Siphon Sold, but looks like he's a Reno deck. Anytime you see Mistress and Mixtures, I always say this. Mistress and Mixtures usually points to Reno because it just does. It just does, the way it works out. It did get siphoned. Alright. You play this plus this, I guess. Yeah, here's where the nerfed Corruptor is a big difference, right? Not being able to go through this in one go. Kind of a big deal. That's a pretty nifty play, though. They both have 5 attack now. Mr. Mixtures is a mecha thing? Okay, that's a good point. He doesn't appear to be that deck. He hasn't drawn at all. He's just kind of playing value stuff. We probably do these two here to get through to face. Yeah, but again, it's the 5 here. Yeah, I guess I hit that, and then... we'll see. Try to hit him with this one.
The end is coming!
Well, we can still deal with that, right? It's not pretty. Might be a twisting. He does need to. I haven't Hero Powered in a while, by the way, which is a little bit awkward because it's my deck. But making him have answers seems right. I don't know. Maybe that's wrong though, because like he only has so much healing, right? So. Thing is, if he does clear me, we just, like, you know, make a 5-5 again. He has to answer it really quickly. Yeah, it looks like I think we're fine. Like, I think we want to exhaust our minion, like, because at some point he's going to play a Void Lord and we're never going to be able to attack with minions again. So, yeah, I don't think we do this too early. Who knows, though? If I hit this every turn, maybe we already won, but... oh, that's... oh, he's doing the, oh, I see. Alright, so our minions are going to be dead. There's no reason to covet them. I can use this, though, right? This might be lethal. If we get another one. Said that. Maybe I'm not supposed to play this turn one. Like, we're supposed to play the more aggressive one and then use this as, like, a removal later. Whatever. I don't like the... But what I don't like is that he can ping this to one and then ping it again, where when it comes later, it's maybe more awkward to... Maybe that's wrong, because he can... This gets tied into AoE later. An incredible discovery. Maybe that was wrong because of, coin being valuable against counterspell, right? Like, we don't really want this to get countered. Best draw now is just the dragon, right? The explorer. Because it is a dragon for this, and then we get another dragon for this, so. I want Leper Gnome. We have Leper Gnomes in our deck, funny enough. That's kind of funny. I mean, this is the most tempo, right? I mean, this... Let's play plus ping, yes. One day, I'll be a real knight. Well, he didn't pick Flame Ward quickly, so it's probably not Flame Ward. Effigy. He got Dreadsteed, well. I can freeze it, I guess. I guess we're freezing it.
We're using real swords.
Nice to meet you.
The fires of vengeance burn bright. That's annoying. To be fair, there were probably better four drops for him to get, right? This guy's got a weird deck. Leper Gnome and Messenger Raven don't exactly feel like those don't go in the same deck. Unless I'm missing some sort of weird new Leper Gnome combo. Anyone know? Interesting that we get rid of that one up to 5-2. It's about to be a 6-2. Okay, I guess he has the, Flame Ward, huh? I mean, is he just dead? He takes 5. 7.
We're using real swords.
Oh, Ice Block. Alright, so it's Ice Block now. Hit him with these, and then that there. I could burn one of the griffins, actually. No, no, I was blocked. Just didn't want to give up. All right. Rexa versus Lunara. The forest fights back. Next time we play Rogue, though, we're gonna keep the diving griffins, because it's a clean answer to the thugs. Which are a problem, right? If you make if they live one turn, all of a sudden they're 5/5s. It's just like it's just too late, right?
None will survive.
All right, so which one do I play? Right, they're all options. Play this one first to set up the growth, but like maybe I coin these two. All right, that kind of makes sense actually, right?
One day I'll be a real knight.
I mean, it kind of locks me into Hero Power, but whatever. We kind of know he doesn't do anything, right? Because he can't spend mana. He has a 1-drop. I really like playing 1-drops in this deck, by the way. Just to have, like the Acorn Bear is, like, the perfect card. Because you play it turn 2. Your quest goes up. And then you play it again. Oh, so he doesn't want to... Interesting. He didn't want to activate his quest there. So, snipe is a bit of an issue here, right? Because this thing is gonna... We don't have to do this. We could just play one of these.
To my side. Job done.
Leoc, probably not the one we wanted. In fact, I don't... I think we wanted Nisha or Upper Moor for sure. Nothing but
such a big bear!
Snip-snap's valuable later. Like, we run out of cards, I guess, with this deck, I guess. I mean, these help us not run out of cards. In fact, all three of these cards draw a card, right? Is this thing done yet? It's still not done. We can't play the 2 5/5s thing yet. He's burning a snipe. Maybe early, premature, because we have some 1/1s coming out here in a minute. They do have a Starfall, which is coming up. I could play 2 snip snaps, go face. We could get a free hit with this thing in. Play 1 snip snap. I don't know what to do, because like if I play the dragon, they could both be dead and I have no more dragons. Maybe that's fine. I think the ideal way to play the hammer is to play the dragon as you're attacking, that way you like guarantee it, right? I think it's not worth much. Maybe I'm supposed to hold on to it. I mean, I have 2 more, so whatever. Still at 27. If he starfalls one of these, this lives. He can't do that. He has to starfall this one. Alright, so we can faceless these two, ping that one. Seems like a plan.
How about a new life? How about a new life?
Although I could just attack that with my face. Maybe that's better. Oh shit. Oops. We lost some value there. I could just trade these in because of swipe and stuff. Yeah. Definitely messed up. We should have traded the two. I think we should have traded these and then gotten extra leopard gnomes. Maybe I shouldn't even play that. I assumed I wanted to. Maybe I overthought that. Alright, so he's looking for Starfall. We play a dragon, draw a card, hit him again for 6 with the hero power. We could just play Baku. I mean, shit. At some point. I'm board locked. Maybe he's taking advantage of that. He's just guaranteed. Like, I can only do so much, right? I mean, it's a lot. It's 6, 8. And 12, it's like half his life. Maybe I just play this because, like, when I have the good opportunity, I think I do. The big ol' whelp lets me attack with a weapon, hero power, but then it gets Starfalled, right? Where this one survives Starfall. Fight face is the correct... Well, no, he wants to kill the... Okay, so he's got swipe again. What is that? Starfall? No swipe. Order? He just wants to play. Like, what's he doing? Playing. Okay, I'm not sure.
not welcome.
Nice to meet you.
Maybe I don't hit, play these. Because they die to Starfall. Because you can now you can Starfall the Baku and it does die. But then the dragon lives. Get two double Starfall.
The jungle provides.
Stealth and taunt, not a combo, technically. Order? He should have done that first. That draws, right? Do we win? So we got this hit here, and then it's like we win. He's an innervate.
Slay them!
First.
I'll play maybe one more game of this, and then at some point I do want to go back into the battlegrounds because the battlegrounds have changed, right? I haven't played the new battlegrounds since they put in. Or they took out the amalgam. I did play a couple times when they added Bran, and I got Bran once. Bran was like stupid rook. I'm not sure what they thought about the balance of Bran because like it's just like just free value. Like all the heroes that are good kind of give you that free value, right? Like Yogg, turn one Yogg, you get to reroll and get a bigger minion, or and then turn five you get that double minion. It just puts you ahead, right? All right, so like even if you don't Yogg at any point after turn five or the third fifth coin. Anyway, here's this again. Turn one, am I supposed to keep it against Paladin? If we're assuming we're playing the same deck, are we playing the same guy? No, but if we're assuming we're playing the same deck, this might be too slow, right? Ironically, he is slow too because he builds up minions. I think if I do keep it, I have to keep all the ones though. Because we need to be able to go like play a one, play this in a one, and then hero power in a one. Right? Let me just play these two. But I need more ones, right?
First kill.
Alright, we'll kill it, I guess. Maybe I'm not supposed to kill it. Maybe I'm not supposed to kill it. I have a lot of damage. We have 3 damage here, 3 damage here, so we have 6 damage on the board to deal with. Oh, but we can't target that? Cheating! Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Alright, that helps me get rid of it, right? But which do I want to keep? Interesting. I guess we're done with this one. That's a gnarly start, man. You can do this in standard, by the way. Coin fly fish into turn 2 fairy dragon. That's a big one for sure. So we do get the free hit on this. It means this has to go away. Alternatively, we can hero power that. Trade, play this thing and this thing. I mean, I might as well get the free hit, right? Plus, we can go face. No, because I have to protect this thing. Yeah, I have to trade it. Just keep picking them up. Maybe that one's better, because it's kind of the same thing, right? So, turn five, what am I doing? We have hero power. The problem is if he true silvers this down, then I don't have a dragon to use this. Whereas if I get this, I guarantee get a dragon again. Kind of like guarantee the dragon, right? Guy's got a cool deck already. Looks like he's doing menagerie stuff, right? He's definitely doing menagerie stuff. That's pretty scary. I do have a poison to kill it. Do I use my face? I think so. Alone. getting low here, but we are ahead. We haven't seen a wild card. No, this is a wild card. Or no, wait. I think this is in standard still. Yes, Amalgam is in standard. So so far we haven't seen a wild card. Damn, man. This thing is... Zamba is really good, right? What do I even do? Do I start going face? It's like too late to go face because I'm like lower than him. Guess we see what this does. Amorous is a cool one. But like I have no hand. I guess, I mean, Deathwing and Hunt and Face Hunter kind of makes sense too, actually. I'm pretty sure it's one of these. Because this one, I think we actually take Deathwing. And I could kill that if I'm scared of another Toxfin. Deathwing is 4 turns away. I don't know if I can live for 4 turns, guys. We have to try, though.
One day, I'll be a real knight.
Kind of nervous about that guy. Maybe that's wrong. I mean, I missed 3 damage. Oh, he's going to magnetize it? Uh-oh. Oh, what? I want to see what that was. All right, well played. Wow, you made it to the end of an extended gameplay video. If you really do like the deck, make sure to check the link below to join in on any of the Hearthpwn discussion. I will see you guys next time.